This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the addition of signed numbers, or positive and negative numbers. So in order to do this, I have to discuss absolute value for a second. So just to remind you about absolute value, the absolute value of a number is the value of the number regardless of whether it was originally positive or negative. So the absolute value of negative 5, using absolute value notation, I'm going to have these two vertical bars and a negative 5 in between. The absolute value of negative 5 is 5. And the absolute value of positive 5 is also 5. In other words, we're taking the value of the number regardless of whether it was originally positive or negative. Okay, so with that in mind, let's talk about the addition of signed numbers. And I'm going to explain this by talking about a game. Let's say we've got a game, and in this game, you start out with 0 points, and every time you win a point, you get a chip with a positive sign on it. So in the first round of the game, if you got 2 positive chips, you would have 2 points. And maybe in the second round of the game, you got 3 more positive chips. So you've got 3 more points. And now we could count those chips. They're all positive. They're all the same. And we would end up with 5. So we could say that a positive 2 plus a positive 3 equals 5. And this is something you're probably used to already. Now, let's see what happens if you play the game again and you're not as lucky. Let's say that the first round, you didn't get positive chips, you got negative chips. Each negative chip means you've lost a point. So if you get 2 negative chips, now you started out at 0, and now you're at negative 2. And maybe in the second round, you've got 3 more negative chips. Well, if we want to know where you are at the end of this game, we can count the chips. They're all the same. They're all negative. You've got 5 chips, and since they're all negative, that means you've got a negative 5. So that means that if we add negative 2 plus negative 3, we'll end up with negative 5. Now, looking at these two cases where we had in both cases, we had the same signs all the way through. We had either 2 positive numbers or 2 negative numbers. What we could say is, if the signs are the same, just add the absolute values and give the sum, whatever you get, the sign that both numbers had. So if we add the absolute value of 2, which is 2, the absolute value of 3, which is 3, we add those together, we get a 5. They both were positive, so it's a positive 5. When the numbers were both negative, we could add their absolute values. Absolute value of negative 2 is 2. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3. We add 2 and 3 and we get a 5. Since they were both negative numbers, we end up with a negative 5. Okay, now, let's see what happens when you've got both positive and negative numbers. So now you've played this game, and on the first round, you get 3 positive chips. On the second round, you get 2 negative chips. Now, we can't just add up the total number of chips because they're different kinds. There's positive and negative. But, you know, if you think about it, if you get 1 positive chip and 1 negative chip, they kind of cancel each other out. So I could take pairs of positive and negative and cancel them out. So I'm going to cancel out 1 positive chip and 1 negative chip. I've got another place where there's a positive chip and a negative chip, so I'll cross those out. And now when I look at what I have left, I just have 1 positive chip. So that means if I add up a positive 3 plus a negative 2, there were 3 positive chips and 2 negative chips, I end up with a positive 1. Now, I couldn't just add the total number of chips because they were different. So since they were different, I'm going to take the difference of the absolute values of those two numbers. So the absolute value of 3 is 3. The absolute value of negative 2 is 2. To find the difference, I'll subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. I'm going to subtract 2 from 3, and I get a 1. And then, to decide whether my answer is positive or negative, I'm going to see what number, what absolute value number was bigger. Well, the 3 was bigger than the 2, and the 3 originally had a plus sign, a positive sign. So that means I end up with a positive number. Okay, so let's try this one more time. Let's say the first round that I play, I do horribly. I have 5 negative chips. So I've got a negative 5. And then in the second round, I do a bit better. I have 3 positive chips. So I want to add a negative 5 plus a positive 3. Well, by looking at the chips and canceling out pairs of positive and negative, I can cross out one pair, let's see, 2 pairs, and then 3 pairs, and I see that I end up with 2 negative chips. So I know that negative 5 plus positive 3 equals negative 2. Without resorting to the chips, without using the chips, I can say, okay, the two numbers were different, so I have to take the absolute value of their difference. I have to take the difference of their absolute values. Okay, so the absolute value of negative 5 is 5. The absolute value of 3 is 3. The difference between 5 and 3, I would get that by subtracting the smaller number from the bigger number. 3 from 5 is 2. And then the 5 was the bigger of those two numbers, and it originally was negative. So that means my answer is going to be negative. Okay, so the basic rule is going to work like this. When both of your numbers have the same sign, you add their absolute values, and then you give the result whatever sign the numbers both had. When your numbers have different signs, you take the difference of their absolute values, and you give the result the sign that the larger of the two absolute value numbers had. Okay? That's basically how this is going to work. Now, there are other ways to understand the addition of positive and negative numbers, so I'm going to do a few more videos. They'll all end up with the same rules, but if this didn't quite work for you, you might want to stick around to watch the next one. Okay, take care, and I'll see you soon.